everyone, I'm Udit. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the systems design interview that comes up for front-end engineering candidates. There are plenty of companies which do a front-end systems design round for candidates. Facebook, Netflix, Google, Amazon, Atlassian are good examples. And these differ sufficiently from traditional systems design interviews that it's worth investing a little bit extra into preparing for them. At the end of this video, you should have three key takeaways. One, what your interviewers are looking for and what therefore these interviews end up usually covering. Two, some tips on how to crack them. And thirdly and finally, a couple of recently asked interview questions that you can practice against. First topic then, what your interviewer is trying to assess. Your interviewer is trying to understand your ability to solve a complicated front-end engineering design problem. Or in other words, can you architect a high-level solution to a problem that has multiple front-end concepts and components? Ideally, you're going to cover a range of topics that are going to prove relevant in the actual job. So browsers, the DOM, performance, API design, etc. And there are three things that they're specifically looking for. One, technical skills, reflected to your knowledge of different technologies, awareness of side effects and system interactions, the trade-offs involved, and the ability to build something that is flexible and scales effectively. Let me give you an example. So if you're talking about loading information, are you going to use long polling or WebSockets? Which could be a better fit for your use case and why? Would the longer latency of long polling be a problem, or is the bi-directional support that WebSockets offer better for what you're designing? What are the other options? Could you just use server-side events here? So these are things that they're essentially going to want to look at. The second thing is structure and approach. Do you scope the problem? Do you clarify requirements or constraints? Do you have a methodology that you follow? Did you dive straight into the problem and then jump around within different topics, or did you come up with a framing of how you're going to solve this problem? Did you drive the discussion, or were you passively reacting to what your interviewer moved you to? Thirdly and finally, communication and collaboration. So how do you interact with your interviewer? Are you able to explain your thinking and go into the right level of detail? Do you have a partnership approach to solving this problem? We have five tips, and this is probably the most critical part of this video. Tip number one, scope and clarify. This may be the most critical tip because since these questions are super broad, you really want to narrow down definitions into something you can actually attack in the 40-45 minutes you typically have. There's also a major side benefit in that it lets your interviewer choose which areas they want to focus on, since they'll typically have a short list of things that they want to assess you against. Some good questions to discuss at this stage is, how many users are we talking about? What's the experience going to be like potentially while we are waiting for a confirmation message? Do we have to take into account different error states or latency requirements? Are there any constraints or guidance around messages or around storage? What operations are we going to need to support? So these are all examples of clarifying questions that can really help you narrow down on what the ultimate system is that you're going to try to build. My general recommendation is then leading into step two, which is to have a very methodical approach to attacking these problems. Broadly speaking, a good idea is to split things into UI architecture, data entities and API, and front-end storage or data store layers, since this is typically how you'd design a system in real life. And then within these, discuss concepts like performance, efficiency and scale, as well as potentially product-specific nuances like time zones or scrolls or accessibility. Which then brings me to my third tip. Watch out for hints, because let me give you an example. Let's say you're designing some kind of calendar element and your interviewer asks, are you sure you just store a single timestamp for this event? This is an explicit guidance from them that you're getting that you might be either missing something or they're looking for something more. Maybe you should be storing a start time and an end time, or maybe there's some complexity related to time zones that you've missed. So use this kind of hint as an opportunity to either pivot or clarify and ask, or just explain your thinking, because all of these are wins. Which then neatly flows over into my fourth tip, which is to think out loud, constantly. You're solving a problem and it's super important for your interviewer to know how you're approaching it, and honestly even more so for you, because your interviewer can effectively then course correct you if you're going down the wrong tangent or going down a line of thinking that they're really not interested in. Finally, tip number five, practice. There are three ways to practice. One way is to just practice against yourself. Try to think of the architecture for web apps that you generally use. Google this knowledge. If you aren't able to figure out how they're structured, you'll find loads of thinking behind on engineering blogs such as the one Facebook has, Trello has, and so on. There's also an interview question bank on Prepfully's website that's collected with the help of candidates who've recently interviewed. I'll include the link in the description below. The second way to practice is with friends or peers. This gets you into the groove of an interview setting. It smooths out your delivery. And thirdly and finally, practice with professionals. Prepfully has 14 front-end engineers at the moment. We're onboarding more and more. They help candidates with mock interviews. They've collectively helped hundreds of candidates in the last couple of months, which means they've got great insight into the common mistakes to avoid, as well as advice on how to typically improve. Good. Last section then is practice interview questions. There's a lot more of these on our website, but here's three to get you started. Question number one, how would you clone Twitter's infinite scroll newsfeed? This is a question asked at Facebook last week. Question number two, design the architecture of Spotify's web app, asked of a Google candidate a couple of weeks back. Question number three, create your own WYSIWYG editor. That's a pretty interesting one. Good, that's all from us for this guide then. Once you feel ready for some practice or just want a sense check of your preparation level, you can book a mock interview with a front-end engineer on Prepfully. We've got several from Facebook, Amazon, Google, Atlassian, and a bunch of other companies. As I said before, since they've helped a lot of other candidates, they provide a lot of value in a very short amount of time if you're looking to get an edge. In addition, I'm also going to link to a bunch of useful resources within the description. There's a written guide that goes into more depth. There's a couple of blog posts that deal specifically with certain parts of this interview. So feel free to check those out as well. If you have follow-up questions about this interview or some of the other interview types that come up for front-end candidates, please feel free to ask in the comments below. And if you found this video useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.